Just days before MAGA male bomber Cesar Sayocs' sentencing in New York, new court filings revealed the Fil-Am Trump supporters' dark past. Sayoc was arrested after sending out pipe bombs wrapped in manila envelopes to the president's rivals and critics, including Hillary Clinton, former President Barack Obama, and even CNN. A sentencing memo penned by Sayoc's lawyers stated that a series of traumatic events pushed Sayoc to commit his crimes. The filings revealed that as a boy, Sayoc was abandoned by his father and was sexually abused by his Catholic school teacher. As a man, he reportedly became dependent on drugs, was abandoned by his family, and lost his possessions during the economic crisis in 2007. His lawyers pointed out that the 57-year-old has no prior history of violence against anyone. The memo also noted that Sayoc was born in Brooklyn, New York in 1962, and that his father was one of nine brothers born and raised in the Philippines by a prominent military figure and plastic surgeon, Burgos Topacio Sayoc, and his wife Severina. His mother is an Italian-American named Madeline. The lawyers painted Sayoc as a Trump superfan whose mental illness allowed him to believe in an alternative reality peddled by Trump, as well as hours and hours of watching Fox News. Sayoc's lawyers wrote, "In this darkness, Mr. Sayoc found light in Donald J. Trump. His infatuation with the president began as something personal, not political. When he was most down, Mr. Sayoc relied on self-help books on tape to keep going. Donald Trump's books on success and business were his favorites. And when Trump announced he was running for president, Mr. Sayoc enthusiastically supported him." The filings also revealed that Sayoc was homeless and lived in a van by 2018, that he became more isolated and more dependent on steroid abuse, which increases feelings of anxiety and paranoia, that he came to believe that prominent Democrats were after him, and that he would eventually create and mail 16 improvised hoax devices to scare Trump's perceived enemies. Last March, he pleaded guilty to a New York federal court to 65 counts of sending the devices and spreading terror in the weeks ahead of the 2018 midterm elections. The defense is hoping Sayoc will only be sentenced to just 10 years in prison. But federal prosecutors in their own sentencing memo said that Sayoc should spend the rest of his life in jail. Sentencing is scheduled on August 5. Don Tagala, ABS-CBN News, New York.